Journey, and you will find replacement to the ones left behind. When I was doing the research for this keynote, I wanted to find a local proverb to help describe the journey ahead. As I started my research, I realized there's not a lot of local proverbs that talk about journey, so I wasn't sure if this was the right proverb or not. But as I continued my research, I realized it's perfect. The first part is simple. Journey. We are all on the same journey. Protect our customer data, safeguard our intellectual property, and strengthen our brand. But we're all at different stages of this journey. Some of us have just begun this journey by attending RSA conference here in Abu Dhabi. Many of us have been on this journey for years, and we've seen lots of changes across our industry. And a few of us, well, we might be a little lost. But it's the second part of this proverb that I find most interesting. Find replacement to the ones left behind. Notice it didn't say to bring them with us. It's telling us it's time to find new ways. It's time for us to change. And if we're going to change as an industry, we need to understand a little bit about our history. Information security has always been an afterthought. We layer security controls around our existing IT infrastructure, and we've been doing this from the very beginning. If we truly want to understand the future of information security and the changes we need to make, then we have to understand the future of information technology. So let's start with a few IT trends. The first, and probably most significant, is the migration to the cloud. And I'm not just talking about the use of cloud services. I'm talking about the migration of our IT infrastructures from corporate-owned data centers to the public cloud. Now, many of you in this room are probably not tracking this trend because you don't believe you're going to adopt the cloud anytime soon. But we're seeing trends that there will be growth of cloud service adoption here in the Middle East. The analysts have predicted a 40% growth in the adoption of infrastructure as a service and platform as a service over the next 2 to 3 years. They're only predicting a 20% growth for the Middle East, but we are seeing positive signs of growth for these types of cloud services. The large cloud providers are making major investments into mainland Europe, primarily to address privacy concerns. And I fully expect some of that investment to spill over into the Middle East, making it easier for cloud services to be done right here locally. We're also seeing key strategic partnerships between telecom providers and software providers to offer more and more cloud services within the region. But the biggest factor to me is the global economy. In a competitive, slow-growth economy, organizations are going to continue to look at ways to cut costs. And cloud services is a great way to reduce their overall cost structure. And I believe that will continue to accelerate both the growth and the adoption of cloud services. The future of security is the application. The application is the critical component in our digital economy and the digital transformation. It's where we store all of our sensitive data and intellectual property. If we think about it, we're using applications today to do things like talk to our friends, pay bills, and even book travel. And this is only accelerating that digital transformation. But while we're securing the infrastructure, we're not paying attention to the application. And it's only going to get harder the longer we wait, because there are new development techniques evolving every single day that are changing the way we build applications. Containers are changing the way we develop applications. You can now distribute application development to small teams all around the world, reassemble all those containers to build a single application. And this is speeding up the pace of new application development. DevOps is changing the way we deploy applications. Continuous development and deployment will become the norm, not the exception. This means we can update a single application multiple times any given day. And our existing security processes and tools are not ready for this amount of change. Microservices are changing the way we communicate to application. These new distributed communication channels are changing the way applications communicate. And again, our security tools and processes are not ready to monitor those new communication channels. And finally, as we continue to move our IT infrastructure into the cloud and adopt more cloud applications, we're going to continue to see a shift away from traditional endpoints to the mobile devices. We already use our smartphones and tablets more and more as part of our daily activities, and this trend will only continue. The caution here is that we're making investments to the traditional endpoint today that may not transition to the mobile future. So we need to be cognizant of all these changes as we think about what do we need to do for information security. The problem is our approach to security is outdated. Defense in depth has allowed us to deploy isolated point solutions, creating layers of security defenses. The problem is we've never done a good job of interconnecting those layers, and this has created gaps in our overall security defenses. And this is where the attackers are hiding. It's hard enough to solve these gaps when we own the corporate data center, but it's only going to get harder as we move our IT infrastructure into the cloud, and these gaps are going to get bigger. We need to change our approach to security. It's time to transform security. It's time to address security as a comprehensive set of capabilities working together to improve our overall security program. If I'm going to continue this journey, I'd rather drive than walk. Now, I laid out this concept last year. Focus on capabilities, not tools. The same holds true for the future. Last year, I laid out a new security map, 6 core domains of capabilities that you should focus on for your security program. The problem was, a map wasn't enough. You wanted directions. As I traveled around the world talking to various customers and prospects, I always got the same question: can you help me with the transition? So this year, I want to provide directions for the journey ahead to help you with your security program. But before we can begin, we need to prepare for that journey. On every journey, we're going to face gaps, and we need to be able to bridge those gaps to continue on. So let's identify some of the key elements we need to think about in order for us to bridge the gaps for this future journey. It starts with our foundation. Without a strong foundation, our bridge will collapse. And here we'll focus on the visibility domains of discover and assess to help build the foundation for our bridge. Now that we have our foundation in place, we now need to span the gap. And here we focus on the context domains of monitor and analyze to help us span the gap and support the future road. Now we're ready for our road. And here we focus on the action domains of respond and protect to build the future road, to bridge that gap. Now that we have these key elements in place, let's begin our journey. The journey from defense in depth to comprehensive security will experience delays. There are a number of gaps along the way that we will have to address in order to continue on. But to start, we need to inventory all of our assets. We can't protect what we don't know, and we can't protect critical assets from unknown or unauthorized assets. We need to have a comprehensive inventory of all of our authorized and unauthorized assets in our environment. We need to continuously monitor device vulnerabilities. Device vulnerabilities will continue to be one of the primary attack vectors for our adversaries. Now, eventually, as we move our IT infrastructure into the cloud, these will get minimized. But in the meantime, we will have to continue to focus on the device vulnerability. We need to assess application vulnerabilities. Applications will replace device vulnerability as the primary attack vector for our adversaries in the future. And we're going to have to do more than static analysis of our source code or dynamic analysis of the running application to protect these new applications that we're developing. We need to audit security configurations, and not just of our hosts and our networks. We need to audit the configurations of our applications, our cloud services, and our cloud infrastructure. A single misconfiguration in our cloud infrastructures could open up all of our assets and applications to attack. These first four steps provide the visibility elements needed for us to continue our journey. So let's continue. We need to monitor all logs. Again, not just our host and network logs, but we need to monitor the logs of our applications, our cloud services, and our cloud infrastructure. This is where new attacks will be focused, and we need to monitor these new technologies if we want to protect our environments. We need to monitor all user access. User, data, and application controls are the controls of the future. We need to monitor user access to both data and applications to understand both normal and abnormal behavior. User behavior will be one of the primary indicators of future attacks. We need to monitor all network traffic, not just our perimeter traffic. We need to monitor our internal traffic. Now, this is a challenge when we own the corporate data center, but this is only going to get harder as we move that IT infrastructure into the cloud. This is one of the areas where we will have a major gap in the industry that will have to be solved over the next few years. These last three steps provide the context needed to prioritize the final leg of this journey. We need to respond to all incidents. With prioritized context, we can now focus on the most important incidents. This will help us protect our most critical assets and data during an attack. But it also provides the foundation for the last and final step of our journey. Automate remediation. Now, this is the step that will take us the longest as an industry to achieve. It requires us to build trust. Trust in our data, trust in our analytics. But once trust is achieved, new techniques like continuous development and deployment in the cloud will actually allow us to implement this, at least technically. We have arrived at our final destination, comprehensive security. We are now ready for the future. As you start or continue your security journey, use RSA Conference here in Abu Dhabi to network with your vendors and your peers. It'll provide you an opportunity to learn from us, challenge us, and work with us. Together, we can reach our final destination. Thank you.